this picture in my album, large and small of every kind. I close my eyes and see the Rebbe's picture in my mind. The Rebbe's picture on my bookshelf, near Sefer HaMitzvahs, always stays, reminding me that I must try to follow in his ways. The Rambam tells us that the mitzvah to cling on to HaShem means that we should learn from tzaddikim and try to be like them. The Rambam tells us to find people like whom we want to be. The Rebbe is the best example I have found for me.
Before I go to school, I like to say brachas from my great-grandfather's siddur. It's old, but I like it because everyone says it looks like the Rebbe's siddur. My little brother likes to daven too. He doesn't know how, but he often takes a siddur and does just what I do. But sometimes I find it hard to keep my mind on the davening. Like yesterday when we were in the middle of Ishtabach, I noticed my friend Yankee swaying back and forth. Funny, I thought to myself, recalling yesterday's baseball game. That's exactly what he does right before he hits the ball. That was a great game, I thought. I never saw Mendy run so fast in his life. Then, suddenly I realized that I shouldn't have let my thoughts wander. I wish I could learn to concentrate more when I daven.
Yes, there is a way that we can think of what we say. The Rebbe shows us how a yid should daven to Hashem. We'll look right at each letter. This will help us daven better as we say the words inside and concentrate on them. And when we go to shul, remember that we've gone to daven to Hashem, not to check what's going on. Try to be attentive and follow as we should. Let's start now, we've seen just how we know we really could.
It feels good to know that you belong to the greatest army in the world. It's the greatest because everyone is always on the winning side.
The Rebbe tells us that girls can be excellent soldiers in Hashem's army. I'm proud to be enlisted and I know I can fulfill my missions.
Me too, me too, me too.
It's not so easy to understand how everything children do can be very important with a world full of grown-ups. But the Rebbe says we can make such a difference.
The Rebbe says we shouldn't wait till we're older and we know much more. Whatever we know now, we can teach somebody else.
Most important, I feel that I really must make sure to be ready. The Rebbe says that just as the children were first to recognize Hashem when the Jewish people came out of Mitzrayim, it is going to be us children who will bring the Geula.
Especially the children, the boys and the girls. They have long, each like the young kids, and they saw the Rivka, Rachel, the Leah.
Shema! Yisrael!
Tati?
Yes, Benjamin.
We watch many videos of the Rebbe giving people different things like lekach and dollars.
Tanya's and contrition.
Kosher bracha.
Why? People can give their own dollars to tzedakah. And everybody has books on Chassidus at home.
So why does the Rebbe give these different things out to people again and again?
Well, let's think about giving. We all give things to others, don't we?
Sure, like I gave my coat to Cousin Yitzi because it was too small.
And I gave Golda a surprise gift because she gave me a ball. And I gave Mimi some cookies so she can tell me if I was a good baker.
I love to give Smiley a smile because he smiles when he thinks it.
Do you see? You all had your own reasons for giving things to others. Yet the Rebbe teaches us more about giving. The Rebbe is not giving out dollars to the people because they're poor. And the Rebbe is not giving out books on Chassidus because they're not learned. When the Rebbe is giving, he's taking the first step towards getting good things done. The person who receives the dollar will give its value or more to tzedakah. The person who receives the book of Chassidus will learn it and teach others what it says. The person who receives kosher bracha will try to make himself like a cup that can be filled with Hashem's blessing. A person who receives lekach thinks about how he, too, can bring more sweetness to others. And in giving to each and every person, the Rebbe helps us all feel part of something really big that includes everyone. You know, this reminds us of the most important thing that was given to us, the mission to do all that we can to bring the Geula.
Take it from Yad Mamush in our name.
Every day we like to play with kids from our own neighborhood. It's fun to be with them, you see they make us feel so good. Cousins who we know so well, children who live down the hall. It's fun to share with friends who care, it's not hard at all. Mitzvah, Avas Yisrael, it seems so easy. With people who are fun, but mitzvah, Avas Yisrael, the Rebbe shows us, it's towards each and every one. People come in different shapes, in different size and color too. They may not be like you and me, but they're our fellow Jew. When people come from far away, with different habits, different views, they may not click with the friends we pick, but they're our fellow Jews. Mitzvah, Savas Yisrael, can be so easy when the person is like you. But mitzvah, Savas Yisrael, the Rebbe shows us, it's towards each and every Jew.
Thanks for helping me with my speech practice, Hami. It's still so hard for me to say the R sound and the TH sound.
Well, you always help me with my Hebrew. You're so lucky you come from Israel. If it weren't for you, I would still be learning Kamatz Aleph Ah.
You mean Kamatz Aleph Ah?
Oh,
no, I was Cholam Aleph.
Ah.
That's Pasach Aleph.
Oh, let's just get on with your speech practice. Mrs. Levy said that I should read the card and you should repeat what it says by watching your mouth in the mirror. Okay? The first card says, my name is Devorah Leah.
My name is Devorah Leah. Oh no, I meant to say, my name is Devorah Leah.
Great. Next card. This is America.
This is America. No, I meant to say, this is America.
Good. Next card says, instead of saying bad, say not good. Wait a minute. Why did Mrs. Levy give you this sentence? It doesn't have an R or TH sound for you to practice.
Oh, that card probably got mixed up. It's supposed to come at the end. Mrs. Levy said the speech class is not just for learning how to pronounce a word, but also to know which words to use.
Hey, I never thought of it that way. That means everyone could use a speech class.
Right. Mrs. Levy said that we can learn from the Rebbe how to choose better words in our speech. Like, instead of saying how bad something is, we could say, it's not good. Instead of saying that person did an avera, we could say that he did the opposite of a mitzvah and needs to correct himself.
But if the Rebbe is careful about not saying words like bad or avera, maybe I should think about some of the really not nice words that I sometimes say.
There, you just did it. You said not nice instead of saying bad.
Hey, honey, why are you looking so downcast? Doing the mitzvah with more simcha, that's what Hashem really wants. Hey, Yankee, where is your chayus in learning? A little more zest, give it your best, that's what Hashem really wants. This is how we begin each day. Moide ani, with joy we say. Ashreinu, matrich okeinu, we are happy, we are yinin. We see the Rebbe's simcha glow. In all he does, he makes it show. With lebedikait, we'll do what's right. Our simcha is not hidden.
Sure. Let me tell you a story about the Rebbe. One Friday afternoon, the Rebbe called a bachar and asked him if he would do something very special for him.
What was the bachar's name?
The bachar's name was Moshe. And the Rebbe asked Moshe if he would take some Shabbos candles and visit a lady in the hospital.
Why was she in the hospital? Did she have a baby?
I don't know exactly why she was in the hospital, but the Rebbe thought it was a good time to have someone go and teach her about Shabbos candles.
he asked the bacher to ask her if she would light Shabbos candles. And he asked the bacher to call him right away and let him know if she agreed to do that.
Did she agree?
Well, he went to the hospital, and he got to the hospital, he came in, he looked around, he saw where the elevators were, he went, he rode all the way up to her floor, went down the hall, found her room, and he knocked on the door. And then he came in, and he introduced himself, and he told the lady that the Rebbe had sent him specially to her to teach her about Shabbos candles and to ask if she would agree to light the candles with a bracha. So she lay back in her bed and she thought about it, and then she said, yes, you can tell your Rebbe that I will light the Shabbos candles. And the bracha was very happy, and he wished her a full shlema, and he wished her a good Shabbos, and then he realized, oh my gosh, and he went and he rushed home. And he got home just before Shabbos.
Why was he so late?
Well, the hospital was very far away. He had to take 3 buses to get there. But as soon as he got into the house, he went to the phone, he called the Rebbe, and he said, Rebbe, the lady agreed to light the Shabbos candles.
You mean he talked to the Rebbe on the phone?
Yes, he talked to the Rebbe on the phone.
What did the Rebbe say?
The Rebbe said what a person is supposed to say when somebody does something very nice for them. The Rebbe said, thank you.
But Moshe was supposed to say thank you. Why did the Rebbe say thank you?
Well, why should Moshe say thank you?
Because the Rebbe was giving him a privilege to do something.
Well, that's right. And I bet Moshe thought exactly the way that you do. But the Rebbe is always very careful to thank someone who does something for him. At a Fabrengen, when someone pours wine for the Rebbe always says thank you. And when the Kohanim come down from saying Birkas Kohanim, the Rebbe always says Yashar Koyach. Now, there aren't a lot of people who thank a Kohen just for doing what a Kohen is supposed to do.
That was a nice story. See you later. Oh, thank you.
Sometime soon in the afternoon, Zalmi'll get his homework done. Because right now, every time somehow, there's something else that's fun. There's the trampoline, you know what I mean, and games to play as you can see. There are tapes to hear and cars to steer, he's busy as can be. He chooses to ignore the clock that's ticking by nonstop. He said it once before, I wish the clocks would go away and stop reminding me each day. Tick, 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 you have to be quick to your schedule stick, no time for shtick. I wish the clocks would go away and not control my day. Mushki loves her new warm gloves. She likes the things that mommy buys. But above the rest, what she likes best is the book bag just her size. It's bright blue with pockets too. It came with all you need and more. Pens like Parker's, magic markers, stickers, pads galore. Mushki wishes it hadn't had the little book to write assignments in. That small green spiral pad, it always tells me what to do. Study, practice, and review. Write each line from letters fine. Do page 9 have parent sign? I wish the pad would go away and not control my day. But we can see how things can be when each moment is used right. A life of say there now, not later. The clocks are in our sight. A person is glad with an assignment pad. He knows just which jobs must get done. The Rebbe shows that he who knows has time for everyone.
Thank you. Before you touch the keyboard, Mendy, make sure your hands are clean.
And please take care, no fingerprints on the computer screen.
Keep all the discs in order. You won't find them if you're sloppy.
And when you handle software, careful not to bend a floppy.
Yes, computers do need special care, but Mendy, you must be aware that mitzvahs also need that touch, because they matter very much. The Rebbe shows us how we should fulfill and truly treasure the Eibishter's will. Mitzvos behiddur, care and attention, done with kavana and intention. Every mitzvah done just right helps fill the world with Hashem's bright light.
Picture in my album, large and small, of every kind. I close my eyes and see the Rebbe's picture in my mind. The Rebbe is the best example of how I would like to be, and as I follow in his ways, his smile follows me. I will try my best to daven, looking at each letter. I will be an active soldier, making the world better. I'll have more avas Yisrael, chayus in all I do. I'll try to do mitzvahs behider and always say thank you. I will try to be on time and complete my task, and I just might get them done before my mother asks. I will be so very careful of the words I say, and I will do my best to bring Yula now today. We are learning from the Rebbe, these are some ways how, and we're yearning like the Rebbe for Mashiach now. We are learning from the Rebbe just what we should do, and we're yearning like the Rebbe for Mashiach Tzidkenu.